Hello kids, good morning to you all. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing great at your home. I'm Khushbu Patel from Saraswati Group of Education and I'm taking your science subject as you know. Now kids, today we are going to start with the explanation of chapter number 2. In the last session of chapter number 2, we have studied the hard words, or you can say the vocabulary words of this chapter. Now, we are going to start with the explanation of this chapter. So, as you all know that before I start the explanation, you all should have your textbook. So, I hope you are having your textbook. In that, you have to open chapter number 2. What is the chapter's title? It is Animals in Their Surroundings. Right? We know that we can see different type of animals on the earth. Some are small, some are big, some are too large. Some are living on land, some are living on tree. Some of the animals are living in forest area. Some of the animals are living in, water also. Right? So we can say that different type of animals are present on the earth. All that animals are living at a different place. Right? So that is what? It is considered as their living area where they can live freely. They can get their food. Right? And of course, they can get the shelter. Now see kids, when you are at your home, how do you feel? You feel relaxed. You feel safe. Why? Because you can do anything what you want to do. Right? Same way. For animals, forest, water and other landforms are their natural home, in which they are feeling safe. They are living freely. Right? So about all that thing, we will study in this chapter. So are you all ready? Okay. So I hope you all have opened chapter number 2 in your textbook. Right? So I am reading, you will also read with me. Right? First, let me take my textbook. See, different animals are found in different places on the earth. Right? As I have told you that there are so many animals, from tiny animals to the large animals. Right? They all are living on earth. But have you ever seen all that animals are living at one place? Like if I say that the way we can see the cow, buffaloes and dogs and cats in our street, same way we can also see the lions and tigers in our street. Is it possible? No. Can we see the dolphins and whales anywhere? No. Yes, animals are there on the earth, but all the animals are having different place to live. Right? What is it known as? See further in your textbook. The place where an animal lives, feeds and reproduces is called habitat. What is the meaning of habitat? If I say it in a simple language, habitat means living place or living area where the animals are living, where the animals are residing. Right? So the place where animals feel safe. They can roam freely. They can have their food. Right? And they reproduce well. That area is considered as the habitat of the animal. Right? You can say that all the animals are having different food habit. All the animals are not eating only one type of a food. The way cow and buffaloes are eating plant products, same way lions and tigers are not eating plants. They are eating other animals. They are hunting the animals and they are eating the animals. That we have seen in the first lesson, if you remember. Herbivores and carnivores. Right? So all the animals are having different food habit. So according to their food requirement, wherever the food is available, right, they are living there. So that place is considered as what? It is considered as habitat, right? Habitat means again living area, right? So kids, you have to underline the definition of habitat in your textbook. From where you will start? See, third line, the place where an animal lives, feeds and reproduces is called its habitat, right? So till habitat you have to underline. Clear? Let's read further. Habitat provides food, water and shelter to the animals. As I have told you that you feel safe when you are at home. You can have a food whenever you want to eat, and whatever the type of a food you want, you can have at your home, right? You are getting shelter. Like if rain is there, so when you are in your house, you are safe, right? You are not getting wet. When it is too much hot outside, you are in your house, you will not feel too much hot, right? So in short, shelter. Same way, all the landforms and other things are the natural home for the animals. So they will select the area where they can have the proper food as well as the proper shelter. So that area in which they are living is considered as what? It is considered as habitat. Right? Clear? Let's read further. Different animals live in different habitat. Like I told you that you cannot find lions and leopards in the street, right? You cannot find any kind of a dolphins or whales or octopus in your street. Why? Because all the animals live in different place. They have different habitat according to their food requirement. According to their body design, all of the animals are having a different habitat, right? And based on their habitat, animals are categorized into different category. That means where the animals are living, based on that, animals have different category. The way we have seen the animals based on their food habit, whether they are herbivores, they are carnivores, omnivores, or maybe scavengers or decomposer, or it may be parasites. Same way, the animals are living in a different place. Based on that, it is categorized into different categories. See in your textbook. Animals living in a particular habitat adapt themselves to their surroundings. Adapt means what? To take, right? Or you can say we get habituated to make the habit to live in a particular area, right? So that is considered as adapt or adaptation. So animal, where they are living, they adapt themselves to live in that surroundings, to live in that area, right? So based on that, we have to study the animals category, right? So see on the next page, there are mainly two categories, right? The two categories based on the animals habitat. The first one is aquatic or water habitat. Now kids, we have studied the aquatic meaning in Harvard. Aquatic means what? Water, right? So the animals which is living in water or water bodies like sea, ocean, river, lake, right? So that all animals are considered as aquatic animal, right? Or they are also known as water animals. And one more thing which is not given in your textbook, marine animals. right? They are also known as marine animals. Now you know that the earth, right, the total area of the earth, from that total area, 70% of the earth's area is totally covered with water. Maybe sea, ocean, or frozen water into the polar region. But in short, we have highest amount of water, right? So water can be of two types. It may be salty water or it may be fresh water. Now, what is the major difference between these two types of water? Salty water, which is also known as saline water. That means the water which contain the high amount of a salt or maybe impurities, right? So that is considered as a salty water, right? You can say that sea and ocean, right? That water we cannot utilize for drinking purpose. Why? Because it is totally salty, right? And the other type of water is fresh water. That means it has very, very less amount of a salt. If I say river, right? If I say lake, if I say dam, right? So the water stored in river, lake, dams or check dams, they don't have a salt. It is considered as a fresh water, right? So many animals are residing in a salty water, like dolphins, whales, of course the largest whale, which is blue whale, octopus, turtles, and many other animals, right? They live in salty water. Some of the animals can also live in a fresh water, right? Like frog, small fishes, crab, right? So in short, the animals which is living in water area is considered as aquatic or water animals. Clear? Read in your textbook. It includes salty water and fresh water, right? So that was the first category of animal. Now the second category, see, terrestrial. I hope you know how to pronounce it, because this word also we have seen in the hard word, right? So terrestrial means the animals which is living on land. As I have told you that 70% of the earth's total area is covered with water, then the other 30% of the earth's area is having land. But land is also having different landforms. That means sometimes you will find that there is a high mountain, sometimes there is a desert, sometimes there is a polar region which is totally covered with the snow. Sometimes it is a grassland, right? So there are different type of landforms. But in all type of landforms, animals can be found, right? So the animals residing on land, living on land, are considered as terrestrial animal or land animals, right? Read. It includes forest, grasslands, desert, polar regions, and mountains. That means you can find animal on polar region also, like penguin. Actually, it is a bird, right? Then polar bears, right? You can find many animals on mountain as well, like yak, right? Sheep, goat, many, right? So on all the landforms, you can find different type of animals. So that is considered as a land habitat, and the animals living on land are considered as a terrestrial animal. Right? Are you all clear till here? Let's go further. Animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. Right? Kids, you have to underline this definition. So if there is a question in a worksheet, you can write the answer easily. So underline the definition of terrestrial animals. Animals living on land are considered as terrestrial animals. Right? Let's go further. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Right? That means the animals which are living in water are considered as water animals as well as aquatic animal. One more word I told you. Do you remember? Yes. Marine animals. M-A-R-I-N-E. Marine animals. So this both things you have to underline. Okay. Now kids, as I have told you that landforms are different. Right. You can see that there are so many trees on the land. Some of the animals are living on land. Right. So based on the different habitat on the land, terrestrial animals are further divided into some more category. So one by one that we have to see. Okay, let's go. Some animals can live both on land and in water. They are called amphibians. Underline the whole statement that the animals which can live on land as well as in water are considered as amphibians. Now kids, we have studied aquatic animals. That means the animals which can live in water. But do you know that there are certain plants also which can grow in water, which is known as aquatic plant. And that plant can be used as a food by different aquatic animals. Right. So here we have to study about amphibians. That means there are certain animals which can survive on land as well as in water. And this type of animal or this category of animal is known as amphibians. If you remember, we have seen this in the hard work. If you remember the picture, right, there was toad, there was one frog, and there was one salamander, which is also known as water lizard, right? The way we can see the wall lizard at our home, right? Same way, there is a species of lizard which can survive in water also. That is salamander, right? So these are the three examples of, yes, amphibians, which can live in water as well as on land. Right? Okay, let's go further. Some animals that mostly live on trees are known as arboreal animals. That means we know that the plants can grow on land very well. Right? Some plants are very tall in a height. Right? And many animals, especially in a forest area, where the trees are very tall, the animals are residing on a tree. That means the full life or most of their life, they are passing on tree. Right? They will just sit on the tree, they will eat the leaves of tree or maybe some soft stem of the tree, and they will just residing on the tree. Right? They all are considered as arboreal animals. Again, this also we have seen in the hard book. Arboreal animals like panda, then sloth, right? Most of their life, they are passing on the tree. They won't come down from the tree. They are just sitting, they are just hugging, and they are just sleeping on that tree. Right? Sloth is one of the arboreal animal which is considered as very lazy animal. We have seen that picture in the Harvard slide, right? Panda is also same. They are passing most of their life on the tree. They are eating just leaves and soft stem. They don't come down from the tree, right? So in short, the animals which are passing their life mostly on trees, they live on tree, they are considered as arboreal animals. Clear? Okay, let's go further. Some animals can fly. They are called aerial animals. Means not animals, but actually all the birds. Right? All the birds, they live on tree. They make their nest on tree. They keep their eggs inside that nest. Right? In short, they are also living on tree. But why they are not considered as arboreal animal? Because they can fly. They don't sit whole time on the tree. They fly, they go in search for food. Right? So the category of terrestrial animal which can fly is considered as aerial animals. Right? The examples of aerial animals are all the birds. Right? Yes, they live on tree, but they can fly also. So they are different from the arboreal animals. Clear? Okay kids, let's go further. In order to survive in their unique surrounding, animals have evolved with their different body structure. Now, what is the meaning of body structure? Right? If I say that lion and dolphins will not look similar, or maybe whale and a sparrow will not look similar. Why? Because one is too big in a size, where one is very small in a size. So in short, we cannot compare all animals with each other because they have a different body design. Their body structure is totally different, right? So about that body structure, we will study in the next session. But before that, in the beginning of this explanation, I told you that all the animals have adaptation to live with the surroundings, right? Maybe they have some fur on their body. Maybe their skin is too thick. Maybe they have a feet which can help them to swim. Right? So that is what it is called as adaptation. Right? To make the changes in their body so that they can live in their habitat freely or maybe safe. Right? So that is considered as adaptation. So to clear the idea of adaptation, I will show you one small video so that you can have the better understanding. So, let us start that video. Are you all ready? Let's start.
Climate and adaptation in animals. Have you ever wondered as to why deserts, grasslands, and rainforests are found only in some parts of the world? Why are there different life forms in every region? Do you think penguins and lions can survive anywhere on the earth? What do you think is the answer to all these questions? Climate is the answer. The climate of a region decides the life forms of the region. Climate is the weather conditions occurring over a long period of time in a given place. The climate of a place depends on factors like distance from the equator, height above the sea level, and distance from sea. The climate is warmer at places closer to the equator than the places closer to the poles. Climate differs from place to place. Come, let's learn about how different animals adapt themselves to different climates in this module.
Stay safe. Bye-bye.